In this week's vlog, I will be photographing the sparrowhawk. But before I can do that, I need to improvise a monopod. At the end of the day, I returned home with a bunch of photos I'm really happy with. Hey everyone, I'm in a wetland reserve today. It's close to my house. It's situated along the banks of the river IJssel. And this is the type of nature I think which the Netherlands is really important for. There are a lot of waders here, there's waterfowl, white-tailed sea eagles are breeding in areas like this. There are kingfishes, spoonbills, lots of birds to photograph. Today I went looking for sparrowhawks. The fear of every little bird around. Yeah. So, a few years ago they were breeding over here as well, and they had a nest up in the tree, right alongside a path. And I think they actually used the people as a kind of protection. Maybe if they are close to where humans are, the humans will keep away the martens and goshawk and other animals that might be a threat to the sparrowhawks. So I came here without any idea where they are really. So at first I had a bit of a look around. And there's this bridge. And at the end, there was a sparrowhawk flying from one side to the other. And that was a clue. So that was pretty cool, right? So then I knew where they were flying. That probably means they were picking up branches from one side and building the nest on the other. So I walked through the bushes all the way to the other side of the water, because then I would have more background and I was more, I had a better sight on the place where the sparrowhawks were flying. I did not bring a tripod. I thought, a tripod, and I have the vlogging camera and everything as well, so I was a bit lazy. But I was feeling a bit sorry for that afterwards, because there were actually some good opportunities for photos. There was some beautiful backlight and those sparrowhawks were flying. So I decided to make a tripod from willow. Well, there's so much willow over here. And at the end I stuck the willow into the ground, and that will just means that it will sprout and it will just continue to grow. Will be a good spot for the kingfisher to fish for. So using my willow monopod, I sat down and waited for a little, see if the sparrowhawks would show up. So cool. I think I got several good shots of the male and the female up in the trees. So what I basically did, that I focused on the tree where they seem to be coming and going for most of the time. And then I just turned off autofocus, because it did not work if they were flying over the water, because that's, yeah, the bird is too small, so the autofocus does not pick that up. From this position, it will be more like showing what kind of landscape they're in. And because they are pretty far away, but that's also cool, you know, not all animal photos have to be portraits. But I think I'm going to try and see to get over there and see if it's possible to make some shots where they're flying towards me. There is a path, so I can sit on the path and I will see quickly enough from the sparrowhawks if they accept that or not. It turned out to be no problem at all. Lots of people come hiking here, so the sparrowhawks are probably used to people. So I sat down and observed the sparrowhawks. Which trees are they getting their branches from, and where are they flying to bring them to the nest? So over time, I could adjust my position to increase my chance for better photos. The sparrowhawks weren't building the nest the whole day. Every once in a while, they suddenly start building. And then they would fly a couple of dozen times over the water. This time I was able to use autofocus, but the A7R4 isn't an A9 or an A1, so quite a few were out of focus. Still though, I ended up with a lot of photos I'm really happy with. Which photo is your favorite? Let me know below in the comments. I really like this last photo. You might have seen it already on my social media, on Facebook or on Instagram. Right, so really successful morning. I will try and see if I can do more with the sparrowhawks this season. I really hope you liked this video. If you did, a like and a comment would be much appreciated. And you can watch my next video over here. See you over there.